Just wanted to give you guys an update on the latest products that we're working on in the LDO group. So to start, I wanted to show you guys where you can go as a resource for all of the all TI LDOs. So if you type in your browser, ti.com/LDO, this is our LDO landing page. It's got a bunch of valuable resources in it. I'd like to highlight, you know, if you, you know, based on what your performance vector is, you can go find the device selection that's right for you. So we have an offering of low noise devices, low IQ devices, wide input voltage devices, and devices based on size. One thing that's new for us is we do have some product promotions. So we have the industry's lowest quiescent current LDO regulator in the market. That's TPS 7A02. I'm going to spend a little time talking about that here in a little bit. And one of the pieces of content that we've recently created are these design challenges. So focusing on what are the problems the LDO solves in your end equipment or application. So we know that at TI, we have over 500 LDOs in our portfolio. So sometimes it can be a challenge to figure out what's the right device for you. So based on what your design challenge is here, we have a list of how do those LDOs help you, along with what are the top recommended products to look into. So today we have five up on TI.com with a plan to put many more up through the year and continuing into next year. So if we focus on one particular section, we have ultra low standby power management to prolong battery life. So the focus here is on low quiescent current devices. So one of the devices I'd like to highlight here is our TPS 7A02. That's our 225 nanoamp IQ 200 milliamp LDO with a fast transient response. So what we've done here is we've had a combination of lowest IQ in the industry, along with one of the fastest transient responses out there. So for portable applications with light duty cycle loads, this is an excellent option to where, you know, when your load turns on, you know, to transmit a signal or to communicate something, it does not have a poor response and your output stays up, allowing your system to function correctly. So if we look just quickly here, this is our first page of the data sheet for the device. We see our load transient response. This is just one value from 1 to 50 milliamps in a 1 microsecond pulse time. We see the output dips by less than 100 millivolts, and it recovers within 10 microseconds. So this is a new technology for us. It's you know, we have it's called a dynamic biasing, where we have a control monitoring the load current. And so when you flip from low load current to high load current, the error amplifier configuration changes to allow for a dynamic AC response. Another thing this allows us to do with this device is while we achieve low quiescent current, we're also able to deliver high PSRR, so high ripple rejection. So, and that's across a wide frequency spectrum. So this is really a great option for single cell portable applications, you know, input voltage range to 6 volts and configurable output voltages from 0.8 to 5 volts. So a really great option here for many of your single cell portable applications. If we go back to our ultra low standby design challenge, another new device that I'd like to highlight to you, TPS 7A24. So I have that pulled up here. This is an 18 volt tolerant 2 microamp IQ low dropout regulator in a SOT 23 package. So it's common across the industry. This is for multi-cell battery applications, supporting up to 18 volt output. So for 12 volt input or for 18 volt input and lower, this is another good option to deliver low IQ while also delivering higher input voltage tolerances. One of the things that's nice about this device is we do have an adjustable configuration here up to 17.75 volts. So if you need a wide output voltage, low IQ LDO, this is another option here. So especially in grid infrastructure and built-in applications, this is another great option. And it's in an industry standard SOT 23 package and pinout here. So if you're familiar with some of the traditional linear regulator devices that you've used to accomplish sometimes, you know, a 12 to 5 volt configuration or 12 to 3.3 volts LDO conversion, this is a great option to save some power, get higher accuracy, and be pin-to-pin compatible with your current solution today. Well, those are two of the devices that I wanted to highlight from a low IQ perspective. As you can see here in our design challenges, we have a large list of low IQ LDOs that fit across the input voltage spectrum. So we can support single cell battery applications. So we have multiple devices for low IQ for single cell battery power, and we also have devices that go up to 60 volt tolerant while delivering less than 10 microamp IQ. And this is one of our focus areas in the LDO team over the last several years and continuing over the next several years, is to continue to push the boundary of input voltage and IQ performance, especially as today's electronics become more and more portable. If you're on the landing page, and if a particular design challenge you're looking for hasn't been uploaded yet, we also have a product selection tool. So if we go here to our LDO product selection tool, this is a quick search of all of the LDO offerings that we have available from TI. And this is everything that's either released and available or available for samples today. So you have some quick search options here where you can sort by AC to DC regulation. You can sort by low noise devices, low IQ, wide input voltage, and small package. And if one of these options isn't quite what you're looking for, we do have a tab over here on the left-hand side that offers many different options that you can filter from. I want to take a look at today that we just recently released is our TPS 7A78. So if you guys are familiar with cap drop power supplies, so AC to DC conversion, this is a new take on a traditional power supply. So in a traditional cap drop power supply, you have a high voltage cap connected to an AC, high voltage AC source, so 120 VAC up to 480 VAC, and you add a high voltage that steps that voltage down, then you rectify it, and then you use a traditional linear regulator to clean it up. The problem is with this solution is your standby power is very high, your efficiency is very low because you usually have a rectified voltage anywhere from 30 to 50 volts. So stepping down to 3.3 or 5 volts is very inefficient. And you have a large board area, large components that are a large solution size for your power supply. So what we've done with TPS 7A78 is we've added an active bridge control and a 4-to-1 switch capacitor to the device to deliver, and also integrated an LDO, so to deliver the optimum efficiency and dropout across LDO with this 4-to-1 switch cap. And the active bridge control is using FETs instead of diodes, so it has much better standby power performance, and it delivers much higher efficiency. So this is a really great option for low power AC to DC power supplies and power conversion when you need it. So we've actually got some reference designs today on TI.com, specifically supporting shunt metrology e-meters, and it's actually using our TPS 7A78 technology. And we also have an offline AC to DC power supply architectures for grid applications. So this one is very nice because it actually shows all of your traditional power supplies for AC to DC voltage regulation. And it goes over the basis of what are the pros and cons of each one. And Vail is especially for low power biases. Vail here, TPS 7A, 78, is a clear winner. So we have many resources on TI.com here for this device. We've got some training videos as well as some technical articles and blogs. So I encourage you, you know, if you're using AC/DC regulation and you have less than 600 milliwatts of standby power, so you know, powering an MCU or MCU with BLE or a, you know, low power op amp or sensor, this could be a great option to save board space, standby power, and improve your efficiency of your system. So I encourage you to go review this device and figure out if it's going to work for your application. And we, you know, as always at TI, we have a great support system to help you through our E2E forums, through direct interaction with your the TI field teams and everything. Okay. One other device I would like to highlight here. So if you go select by wide input voltage, these are traditionally some of our, it offers multiple devices, both from a low IQ perspective as a general purpose perspective. So one device we did just recently release is our TLV767. This is an adjustable and fixed 1 amp, 16 volt positive voltage LDO. This is thought of as, if you guys are familiar with the 1117 linear regulator, that is common across multiple suppliers in the IC industry. This is TI's goal at trying to improve the performance of this and deliver a much better solution. So if we focus on the specifics here, we support up to 1 amp. We are 2.5 volt input to 16 volt output capable. We have an adjustable output and fixed voltages available. And some of the vast improvements we've made compared to the traditional 117 linear regulator is we offer ultra high accuracy, so 1% output accuracy over load and temperature. We've reduced the IQ. So traditional linear regulators are in the milliamps of IQ. This device is 50 microamps of IQ. So from an energy efficiency standpoint, this device offers a vast improvement. So if you have an appliance application where you're using this and you have Energy Star concerns or energy efficiency concerns for your appliances or for your application, this device could help you achieve that. We've also made the device stable with ceramic capacitors, and that's stable with low value ceramic capacitors. So to help save on solution size of your application or your power supply, as well as to help save on cost from having to use those bigger tantalum capacitors. The device is also high PSRR. Its ripple rejection is still 46 dB at up to 1 megahertz. So it holds up very well as a post SMPS regulator. And finally, it's in a much smaller solution size. So the traditional 117 regulator is typically in a SOT 223 package. So anywhere over 20 millimeter squared package, this is in a 4 millimeter squared package. So much smaller solution size. And even with this package size, we're able to deliver comparable thermals to some of the 1117 linear regulators out there. So this is an excellent candidate for your next generation, application or power supply, where you're looking to save on standby power. You're looking to save with your capacitors. You may be looking to lower you may be looking to improve your accuracy, and you just want a cleaner rail. So So those are some of the top devices I wanted to highlight. It's, as always, we're working on many other things in the LDO team. So we've also, we've also got some devices that are low IQ supporting up to 500 milliamps of output current. So that's our TPS7A26. So that's a good option for higher current. So this is the industry leader in delivering high output current, but also having low IQ. So for applications where you portable power, where you also need to deliver high current, this is another good option. One other thing I'd like to point out that we've recently been working on is a new thermal tool. So if we have some thermal information available on certain devices where you can actually go see what your thermal performance looks like, it's something that we've been working on, and it's a request we get commonly in the industry of how do my thermals based on what my input output voltage conditions. So for select devices, we've added on the product folders this thermal calculator. So depending on what device you're looking at, if you want to know what your thermal dissipation is going to look like based on what your conditions are, you can do that. So if we go here and select, 12 volt input down to 1.5 volt output, and we have 300 milliamps of current at an ambient temperature of 30 degrees C, and then we obviously select what our PCB thermal PCB construction is. So we'll select enhanced thermal for this one. If we update, we get our estimated power dissipation here, along with what is our ambient temperature going to be based on our PCB copper coverage area. So this is available for several of our devices. We're continuing to add more devices to this this daily, but this is a great way to figure out how can you make sure that you meet your how do you meet your junction temperature requirements while also achieving the best conversion you can. So I encourage you to go play with this tool if you want to get an idea for how you need to lay out your board based on what device you're using, along with what your input output conversion is, what your current is, and then what kind of PCB you're going to be using. This helps figure out what's the minimum copper coverage area I can have to ensure that I don't violate the device conditions and the boundaries there. So with that, we're working on many other things in the LDO team. We still are working on improving and getting more of those design challenges on TI.com. So today we have 5 of them, and we're hoping to have more by the end of this year, and then to continue to help you guys with product selection based on what your design needs are. We'll continue to work through. We got this thermal calculator. We're continuing to update devices on this on a monthly and quarterly basis, trying to add more devices that are commonly used across the LDO groups. So that's what we're working on, and we continue to have more collateral available on TI.com to help.